afraid to die? No. Do I want to die now? No.
A woman who's lived with AIDS for 26 years shares her story of struggle and courage as the world sets this day aside to work together for an AIDS-free generation. WDSU reporter Casey Ferrand is live in the studio with more on World AIDS Day and how it's being celebrated across the globe.
Now 30 years into the AIDS epidemic, the world unites today in the fight against HIV. But every day, Sheila Fuco and her son fight to live with this disease.
Hey, Carl. Happy World AIDS Day.
In Washington, World AIDS Day is observed with a large red ribbon on the north portico of the White House. In Sydney, Australia, the Opera House is lit in red and the sky is filled with red fireworks. By 6 o'clock, Sheila Fuco is winding down in her Terrytown home, feeling tired from her day.
Physically, my body is wearing down and my body is starting to not want to work.
At the age of 29 and 8 months pregnant with her second child, Fuco found out she'd contracted AIDS from her husband of 4 years.
My private HMO company in 87 called me up and said, "You have AIDS," right over the phone. I was like, "What? Are you crazy? I'm married."
Doctors weren't sure her unborn son would survive.
And they said he'd probably be born, stillborn, or he would die within the first year of life.
He's now 25, living as a model and actor in California.
In the beginning, people made us feel ashamed that we got it. You know, people were saying it was a curse.
Now she sees every day as a gift from God.
All I want now is peace.
While she's grown to accept her circumstances, she still hopes to see more people educated.
I feel that more people are getting infected because more people believe that with all the new drugs out and everything, they can live a long time.
While prevention tools like HIV testing, access to condoms, and risk reduction programs have helped to decrease the spread of HIV, Fuco wants to see a vaccine to keep people from contracting it.
This disease is not over with yet.
And here at home, World AIDS Day is being celebrated at the Art Against AIDS Gala at the New Orleans Museum of Art. It features a silent auction of artwork and performances by Shades of Praise Gospel Choir and Big Deal Burlesque. It supports the No AIDS Task Force and people affected by HIV and AIDS here in Southeast Louisiana. Rachel.
Thank you, Casey. It's estimated 50,000 Americans are infected with HIV every year. More than 1 million people in the U.S. are living with the disease. According to the No AIDS Task Force, for the last 5 years, New Orleans has been among the top 10 metropolitan areas for AIDS case rates and in the top 20 for the past 10 years.